right, the next song we're going to be singing is Trumpet Sounds. Repeat after Rebecca and I.
Praise the Lord with trumpet sounds.
Trumpet sounds. What's another instrument we can praise the Lord with?
A big bass drum.
Okay.
A big bass drum.
Praise the Lord with a big bass drum.
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 Trumpet sounds.
Trumpet sounds.
Trumpet sounds.
Trumpet sounds.
Hallelujah, 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 amen. Kylie, what's another song we can praise the Lord with?
I'm thinking Clashing Cymbals.
All right.
With.
Kylie, I think we should praise the Lord with an electric guitar.
Okay.
Praise the Lord with
trumpet
sounds.
Praise
the Lord with electric guitar.
Praise the Lord with electric guitar.
Electric guitar.
Electric guitar.
Electric guitar.
Electric guitar.
Clashing cymbals.
Clashing cymbals.
A big bass drum.
A big bass drum.
Trumpet sounds.
Trumpet sounds.
Welcome to Worship. Today, provided by Lutheran Outdoor Ministry leaders from throughout the United States, all of them associated together in the organization known as Lutheran Outdoor Ministries, LOM. We're grateful that we have the opportunity to bring this experience to you, recorded in some of the most beautiful places that you can imagine, the camps and retreat centers affiliated with the ELCA. And we're also grateful this morning, we give thanks to God, that our camps and retreat centers are emerging from the grip of the COVID-19 pandemic, and it's going to be a really, really great and exciting summer coming up. Welcome.
This worship is a time to celebrate and enjoy. So as I'm leading the service, if I ask you to do something like stand and you don't feel like standing, don't feel guilty that you have to stand. If you want to stand, if that's part of your faith practice, please stand. However you need to be to enjoy this service, to truly be in it, to worship the Lord, that's what really matters. So let's begin with confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who forgives all our sin, whose mercy endures forever. Amen. Let's confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Have mercy, O God. Against you, you alone, we have sinned. In your compassion, cleanse us from our sin and take away our guilt. Create in us a new heart and give us a steadfast spirit. Do not cast us away, but fill us with your Holy Spirit and restore your joy within us. Amen. As tender as parent to child, so deep is God's compassion for you. As high as heaven is above earth, so vast is God's love for you. As far as east is from west, So far, God removes your sin from you, renewing your life through Jesus Christ. Blessed be God who crowns us with mercy and love. Blessed be God forever. Amen.
Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
This love, how can it?
Let us pray. All-powerful God, in Jesus Christ, you turn death into life and defeat into victory. Increase our faith and trust in him, that we may triumph over all evil in the strength of the same Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Then the man and his wife heard the sound of the Lord God as he was walking in the garden, the cool of the day, and they hid from the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man, "Where are you?" He answered, "I heard you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid." And he said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree I commanded you not to eat from?" The man said, "The woman you put here with me, she gave me some fruit from the tree, and I ate it." Then the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this you have done?" The woman said, "The serpent deceived me, and I ate." So the Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, cursed are you above all the livestock and all the wild animals. You will crawl on your belly, and you will eat dust. And the days of your life, all the days of your life, and I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers, and he will crush your head, and you will strike his heel."
Hi everyone, a reading from Psalm 130. "Out of the depths I cry to you, O Lord. Lord, hear my voice. Let your ears be attentive to the voice of my supplications. If you, O Lord, should mark iniquities, Lord, who could stand? But there is forgiveness with you, so that you may be revered. I wait for the Lord. My soul waits, and in God's word I hope. My soul waits for the Lord, more than those who watch for the morning. More than those who watch for the morning. O Israel, hope in the Lord. For with the Lord there is steadfast love, and with God is great power to redeem. It is God who will redeem Israel from all its iniquities." The word of the Lord. A reading from 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 13 through chapter 5, verse 1. "But just as we have the same spirit of faith that is in accordance with Scripture, 'I believe, and so I spoke,' we also believe, and so we speak. Because we know that the one who raised the Lord Jesus will raise us also with Jesus, and will bring us with you into his presence. Yes, everything is for your sake, so that grace, as it extends to more and more people, may increase thanksgiving to the glory of God. So we do not lose heart. Even though our outer nature is wasting away, our inner nature is being renewed day by day. For this slight, momentary affliction is preparing us for an eternal weight of glory beyond all measure. Because we look not at what can be seen, but at what cannot be seen. For what can be seen is temporary, but what cannot be seen is eternal. For we know that if the earthly tent we live in is destroyed, we have a building from God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens."
All right, it's time for all the children to gather around. Doesn't matter what age you think, if you, as long as you want to gather around, I'm welcome. Some places say, oh, you know, children under five or whatever. If you're 65 and you want to gather around, please gather around for a children's message. Okay, I've got to ask you a question. Raise your hand. Have you ever embarrassed your parents or your brother or sister? Raise your hand. Wait,
Some of y'all, you're not raising your hand. Really? You've never? Oh, you're such good children. I wish I could say the same. I embarrassed my mother once. Ooh. We were in a store, and she was trying to finish up on buying something. I kept trying to get her attention, and she was talking to the woman at the register. And she kept telling me, just a moment, just a moment. And she kept doing, and I don't know what was taking so long, but all of a sudden I shouted out, I need to pee! And everyone in the store turned and looked at me. And my mom said, oh, child, you have so embarrassed me. And then there was another time where my little brother, he was 6 years younger than I am. And so he went out one day and decided he was going to take off all his clothes while he was outside playing. I think he must have been about 4, maybe 5 at the time. And I was outside with him, and the neighbors were just kind of looking at him, and I'm going, oh. Yeah, sometimes we do things that other people feel embarrassed about. Can you imagine Jesus' family being embarrassed by him? Can you imagine that? Well, it kind of happened. In our gospel reading that you're about to hear, Jesus, his mother, his brothers and sisters were a little embarrassed by him. Now, he didn't shout out something embarrassing in the middle of a crowded store. He didn't take off all his clothes and go running around. He embarrassed them while he was proclaiming the gospel, while he was telling people about God. That's kind of strange, isn't it? Jesus reminded, when his family said something to him, he reminded them that what he's supposed to be doing is proclaiming the good news of God. So, there may be some things that you might do. There may be some things that your parents might do or your siblings might do that maybe embarrass you. But no one should ever be embarrassed when someone is proclaiming the good news about Jesus. So I want you to remember that. If you're telling somebody about Jesus and someone tells you, no, don't let them stop you. Keep telling people about Jesus. All right, let's pray. Dear Jesus, we thank you. We thank you for the example you showed us, that we are to always be about proclaiming the good news, proclaiming that God loves us and loves the world. Help us to remember that, even when others may feel a little embarrassed. We lift this up to you in Jesus' precious name. Amen. Thanks for joining me.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
My name is Leah McDougall, and I am the Associate Director here at Luther Park in Danbury, Wisconsin. Today, I will be reading from the Gospel of Mark, chapter 3, starting at verse 20. Then he went home, and the crowd came together again, so that they could not even eat. When his family heard it, they went out to restrain him, for people were saying, "He has gone out of his mind," and the scribes who came down from Jerusalem said, "He has Beelzebul. And by the ruler of the demons, he cast out demons, and he called them to him and spoke to them in parables. How can Satan cast out Satan if a kingdom is divided against itself? That kingdom cannot stand. And if a house is divided against itself, that house will not be able to stand. And if Satan has risen up against himself and is divided, he cannot stand, but his end has come. But no one can enter a strong man's house and plunder his property without first tying up the strong man. Then indeed the house can be plundered. Truly I tell you, people will be forgiven for their sins and whatever blasphemies they utter. But whoever blasphemies against the Holy Spirit can never have forgiveness, but is guilty of an internal sin. For they have said, "He has an unclean spirit." Then his mother and his brothers came, and standing outside they sent to him and called them. A crowd was sitting around him, and they said to him, "Your mother and your brothers and sisters are outside asking for you." And he replied, "Who are my mother and my brothers?" And looking at those who sat around him, he said, "Here are my mother and my brothers. Whoever does the will of God is my brother and my sister and mother." Here ends the reading.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah,
praise God's name.
Grace and peace to you from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. And greetings to you from Luther Hill Ministries. We are one of over 100 camps and retreat centers affiliated with Lutheran Outdoor Ministries. This for us is our holy ground, the rolling hills of Luther Hill Camp and Retreat Center here in LaGrange, Texas, and over at the beach, the Zion Retreat Center on Galveston Island. These places, these holy grounds, are the places in which we gather together around campfires, we sing silly songs, play fun games, and see Christ come to life in holy community. I imagine you have your own patch of holy ground, a camp, a retreat center that's close to home for you. Know that we give thanks for our partnership with everyone that comes onto this holy ground. We especially give thanks to our congregations who invest their children's faith formation with us. It's indeed sacred and holy to be part of that formation experience. I've been a pastor for a while now and served here at Luther Hill Ministries as the camp pastor for about 3 years. And I guess it's a bit of an occupational hazard that now every time I read scripture, I see it through the lens of camp. So I imagine when I read the Gospel of Mark for today, a first-time camper may be coming to sing along for the very first time and seeing an especially enthusiastic staffer and saying to themselves, "That person is demon-possessed." Or maybe a fourth grader, for instance, on day 4 of liberation from their parents and taking no showers that entire time, they kind of snuck that one past their counselor, walking past that fourth grader and thinking to yourself, "That one has an unclean spirit." Or maybe the junior high camper at the very end of the week when their counselor simply says, "Your mom is here to pick you up." And the junior high camper confidently says, "Who is my mother? These are my people now." Our gospel reading today may not come all the way through the lens of camp, but it certainly points to some truth in our world today. Jesus can't even find time to eat. He's pulled away from his family meal. And it comes to light that his family is really worried about him and his safety. Like most family dynamics, it's kind of a tension between worry and embarrassment. They're worried slash embarrassed about Jesus's newfound fame, the attention he's getting, and the conflict that he's stirring up too. The people around him start to say he is demon possessed. He has an unclean spirit. Jesus exits the house, gets up from the family meal, and responds. He says, "Your thesis is flawed. If I was the devil, why would I work against myself?" He says, "A house divided will not stand. A house divided will not stand." Well, here in Texas, we have a lot of lawn ornaments, decorations in people's front yards. And one of the lawn ornaments that I see from time to time is a small flag that simply says, "A house divided." And then it has the emblem for UT, which is the University of Texas at Austin, and A&M, Texas A&M University and College Station. The house divided flag represents that maybe one college student is going to UT Austin, another to Texas A&M, and the house is in holy tension about the rivalry between them. I don't know if that's what Jesus had in mind, but it's true in our world today. In our home, we also experience a house divided. My spouse Matt and I have twin 5-year-old daughters, Emma and Lily. And we often experience a house divided around the TV shows that they really want to watch. So one might want to watch Doc McStuffins, the other might want to watch Paw Patrol, and we're torn in a tension between which one will win. We also experience a house divided in our nation. We put one another in silos, people with opposing views are separated from one another. It creates division and opposition instead of unity. Rather than seeing a person as who they are in the story of their life and a beloved child of God, we simply put labels on them instead of seeking to understand. Well, friends, I think camp is a place to heal some of those dividing lines. Camp, this holy ground, has an incredible opportunity to bring people together, people with different views, different lives, different politics, to gather people around a campfire, to learn to listen to each other well, to learn to love each other well. Here at Luther Hill, we operate by the village system and we partake in something called consensus decision making. Two cabins are paired together for the week to become a village, and then that village travels around to different activities together. For their afternoon activities, they get to decide together what they are going to do. That's where the consensus decision making comes in. You see, there's always a faction of the group that only wants to do arts and crafts every day. And then there's another faction of the group that wants to go to the pond every single day. And instead of the counselor making all the decisions for what they're going to do, the campers work together to find a compromise. They speak truth about what they want to do. They listen well to one another. And hopefully, after a little bit of talking, they come to a consensus on their decision. It usually involves some kind of compromise, like going to arts and crafts every other day, going to the pond every other day, but they listen to each other well and they learn to compromise well. It's like a little workshop of how to live as a faithful disciple in the world. When our campers go out into the world, hopefully, if all goes well, they've learned how to listen well to others, to speak confidently about what they hope for themselves, and to find common ground in the midst of that. I think that is the goodness of camp. It helps us live in holy community with one another. This type of community is powerful. This Christ-like community has the power to change the world by bringing people together, by seeing other people as beloved children of God, and learning to listen to each other really, really well. It stirs up that common ground, the holy ground that we talked about from the beginning. So as I stand here on this holy ground in LaGrange, Texas, I give thanks for the gift of partnership, for the ways that people come to this holy place and learn to love each other well. I give thanks for the gift of fresh air and birds chirping, for the beauty of creation. And I give thanks too for your faithful partnership that pulled camps through the pandemic and allows us to open again safely this summer. I give thanks for you. This is the good news for us today and every day. Amen.
This song is called Brothers and Sisters.
Brothers and sisters, we all have a song to sing. In our own way, we have a message that we bring, oh yeah. God created us to help the world go round, to bring together all that we have found. Brothers and sisters, we all have a gift to share. Show how much we really care, oh yeah. God created us to help the world go round, to bring together all that we have found. Brothers and sisters, we all go our own way. But in the end, we'll meet again, oh yes we will. We'll meet again. Jesus' feet, we'll meet again, oh yes we will, we'll meet again.
Let us profess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
With the whole people of God in Christ Jesus, let us pray for the church, those in need, and all of God's creation.
Lord, we humbly ask that you hear us as we confess to you for those we have neglected, for those we have failed to love, for failing to love ourselves, for all of those things that we have done that have been other than your purpose or your will for us or for your people. For the ways that we have abused others or have abused your creation. For all of those things for which we have fallen short. Oh, gracious God, forgive us, we pray. Lift us up and carry us when we cannot carry ourselves. Continue, we pray, to use us as a blessing. Continue, we pray, to send us out that we might be light in the darkness and blessing in the world. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Gracious God, we give thanks for the church. For the church that exists out here under the trees, and for the church of buildings, of chapels, and anywhere where God's people gather together. We give you thanks. Look over, guard, and bless all of our churches and the people therein, and help us to follow after you in everything that we do. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
God of this place and every place, you called out the first question to human beings, where are you? We get confused and lost thinking that the most important question is, who am I? We wander off paths, not knowing or caring where we are. Along that lost way, we throw stuff away, toss people aside, and trample beloved creatures under our feet. Give the church courage to ask the more difficult question, where are we? May the church be transformed into a garden where the life of all is sustained by our knowing of each and every creature as they are, that may wander in. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Mighty and comforting Lord, we pray for the nations of the world. May those who know hunger be fed. May those living in war and terror know peace and comfort. May those who live in abundance embrace generosity. Help us find ways to live with our global siblings in love and compassion. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Gracious God, we pray for your camps and retreat centers, their campers and staff. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Creator God, we praise you for the wonders of your amazing creation. The web of interconnectedness draws us deeper into the awe of your mighty creative power. We rejoice that our outdoor ministry sites are places to discover, encounter, and experience you in the world around us. You call us to be caretakers of all creation. Help us to appreciate the gifts of land, water, air, plants, and animals. All of it. Help us to be caretakers of your earth as we conserve, reduce, reuse, and recycle as responsible stewards in your world. Let us rejoice for the gifts of your creation. Lord, in your mercy.
Into your hands, gracious God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. All right. Now it's time to share the peace. Now, you may be at home. That's okay. If you've got someone to share the peace with there, share the peace with them. If not, text someone, make a comment, shout it to your neighbors, shout it out into the community, however you might do. For those of you who gathered together, there are multiple ways of sharing the peace without actually embracing or shaking hands. You can do the peace of the Lord, or you can do the peace of the Lord, or peace of the Lord, or if you really want to do it, the peace of the Lord. However you want to do it, let's share the peace with one another. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Jesus.
I've got love.
It's offering time. That means it's a time for us to give of our tithes, our offerings. If you're in church, it would be that time for you to receive your tithes and your offerings that are presented and provided to your congregation. They're given in the glory to God so that your ministry can continue to grow, your ministry can continue to thrive. You look behind me. Kind of looks, yeah, you know, not much. There's growing, but there's some brown. But we're at the beginning of the season. God will continue to give the sunlight, the rain, so that this will continue to grow, to flourish, and to thrive. As you are thinking about the offering and tithes that you're giving to your congregation, I want you to also consider giving an additional offering to your camps. Your camps have gone through so much over the past year. Many have had to close completely. Right now, you can help in supporting the ministries that helped to make this video, this worship today, possible. So I would encourage you, above what you're already committing to giving to your congregation, that you would consider an offering to your local camp. And if you don't have a local camp, then consider an offering to the LOM Network. And you can do so by going to lomnetwork.org. And if you're not sure about camps around, you can also find the list of all of the LOM, the ELCA camps that exist throughout the U.S. So let us now receive our tithes and offerings.
Please join us in singing Gospel Light.
Gospel Light?
That's right, Gospel Light.
Gospel light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine, eh, eh, eh. This
crazy? I'm gonna let it shine. My little under a bushel. Are you crazy? I'm gonna let it shine. Hide it under a bushel. Are you crazy? I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine all the time. All around our neighborhood, I'm gonna let it shine. All around my neighborhood, I'm gonna let it shine. All around my neighborhood, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine all the time. This little gospel light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little gospel light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little gospel light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine all the time. Let it shine, let it shine all the time. Let it shine, let it shine all the time.
Let us pray. God of goodness and growth, all creation is yours, and your faithfulness is sure. Word and water, wine and bread, these are signs of your abundant grace. Receive the gifts we bring and nourish us to proclaim your abiding love in our communities, in our camps, and in the world. Through Jesus Christ, our strength and our song. Amen.
Song for Jesus, you'll be right. Sing a little song for Jesus, you'll be right. Oh, poo-wa, poo-wa, ha-tuna, hey! Poo-wa, poo-wa, ki-wa-ho. Sing a little song for Jesus, you'll be right.
Do a little dance.
Do a little dance for Jesus, you'll be right. Do a little dance for Jesus, you'll be right.
Oh,
poo-wah, poo-wah, ha-tuna, hey! Poo-wah, poo-wah, ki-wah-ho. Do a little dance for Jesus, you'll be right.
Sing really loud.
Sing really loud for Jesus, you'll be right. Sing really loud for Jesus, you'll be right. Sing real song for Jesus, you'll be right.
Sing real song.
Sing real song for Jesus, you'll be right. Sing real song for Jesus, you'll be right.
Oh,
sing a little song for Jesus, you'll be right.
One more time.
One more time for Jesus, you'll be right. One more time for Jesus, you'll be right.
Oh,
poo-wah, poo-wah, ha-tuna, hey! Poo-wah, poo-wah, ki-wah-ho. One more time for Jesus, you'll be right.
End this song.
End this song for Jesus, you'll be right. End this song for Jesus, you'll be right.
Hey. Oh,
poo-wah, poo-wah, ha-tuna, hey! Poo-wah, poo-wah, ki-wah-ho. End this song for Jesus, you'll be right.
Woo! Let us pray together. Living God, as the disciples ate and drank with their risen Lord, we have been nourished with the very presence of Christ. Through this meal, may we be strengthened to keep your word and to proclaim the power of your love. In Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
Thanks for worshiping with us today. And now receive the benediction. May God bless and keep you. May God's face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May you see God's countenance in all that surrounds you. And in this way, may you know peace. Amen.
shines brighter, Jesus shines purer than all the angels in the sky. Beautiful Savior, Lord of the nations, Son of God and Son of Man, glory and honor, praise and adoration, now and forevermore be thine.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord for the sake of the world. Thanks be to God.